You look kind of weak and puny, but I think you'll pull through.
Thank you, sir. Great chap. I wish we had more like him at Annapolis.
Yes, sir. Too bad this is his last year.
You'll make a grand naval officer.
Polo grounds in New York City. Witness this great game between the Army and Navy. Stands are packed, people are standing all over the place, and all eyes are on Fresh Morgan, captain of the Navy.
Double wing back. Smith is back. With the ball pass from center, goes to Smith, it's reversed to Corrigan. Corrigan hits over his own right tackle. He hits the fullback, knocks him down. He's away. Wait a minute. He's boxed in. Craig and Reynolds are coming in. He hits Craig. He flexes him over. Straight out runners, and he's across for a touchdown. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Crash Corey, and captain of the Navy team, playing the finest game of his career.
Wait a minute, son. What do you want?
I gotta see Lieutenant Corrigan right away.
You can't go in there. It's against orders.
But I tell you, I gotta see him. It's important.
Even if I let you in, you couldn't talk to the lieutenant now. He's busy.
All right.
Until I get into my clothes. I'm going over to Professor Norton's laboratory.
Very well, Crash.
What you say is very interesting, Professor Norton. But I still can't believe that this little machine can predict earthquakes.
Not only predicts, but prevents them. If I could get close enough to the source.
Ah, oh, there you are, Lieutenant. The signals are coming in much stronger. Oh, I beg your pardon. This is Miss Compton, staff writer of the Times.
Oh, everybody knows Crash Corrigan.
Was the signal again. They've been sending it every 5 minutes.
They? Just whom do you mean by they?
Professor Norton maintains that these signals must be the work of some human agency, apparently coming from the bottom of the ocean.
I hope you're not going to spring that fantastic yarn about the lost continent of Atlantis.
Exactly. Only now I have some definite evidence. This is pure auricalcum, a metal made by fusing gold and copper. The secret of this process was lost with the Atlanteans.
What does that prove?
Well, according to every test, the idol couldn't be more than a couple of years old. Something made recently.
I found it during a recent trip I made in my rocket submarine in this general location. And this is where the ancient continent of Atlantis was reported to have sunk thousands of years ago. Contrary to popular belief, Atlantis did not sink overnight, but during a period of years. During this time, the people had ample opportunity to construct a roof of auricalcum over the city and keep out the ocean waves. Thus, Atlantis, though lost, still lived.
But, Your Holiness, Unger Khan's men are at the gates. I beg of you to take safety in the citadel.
Poseidon, god of Atlantis, has never forsaken his people in time of need. I promise you he will not do so now. There will be no peace in Atlantis until we have broken the power of this evil usurper, Unger Khan.
Hopeless, exalted one. Our men are outnumbered. The city is about to fall.
Have faith.
I am pleased to report that Sheriff's army has been driven within the walls of the sacred city.
Good. Recall the troops. With those religious fanatics under control, I'll have no more interference with my plans to destroy the upper world.
The fool.
When you do succeed in sending them to the bottom of the sea, Atlantis will rise once more to its former place in the sun, and you will be ruler of all things.
Start the disintegrator.
Sinclair's in ruins. Thousands dead. Hospitals burning. All communication cut off. Red Cross is appealing for doctors. Special trains are rushing supplies to the stricken area. Governor of the state declared martial law, rushing a militia to the scene of the disaster. Stand by for further announcements.
St. Clair? That's only 300 miles from here.
Yes, and according to my calculations, another severe shock will occur any moment. Joe, put that counteracting machine aboard the submarine right away.
Do you mean you're going down and try to stop this quake? What a story this will make for my paper. Let me get to a phone. Can I come along, Dad?
Some other time, Billy.
I have something more important for you, Billy. I want you to take a note to the naval base for me.
Hurry up, Joe. We've got no time to lose.
But, Professor, I don't think it's safe to take the submarine down that far.
We've got to take that chance. Get those things aboard.
Now, quick, give this note to the commanding officer at the naval base. He'll understand. Come on, Joe. I'll give you a hand.
This is not an ordinary submarine, Bill. It's propelled by rocket motors, designed by Professor Norton himself. Yes, it's been tested at 2,500 feet, and he's going to try to reach the bottom this time. I'll tell you more about it when I get back. What? Am I going along? You bet I am.
Hello? This is Professor Norton's boathouse.
Brandy Deep.
Hello? Hello? Hello?
Will you shut up? Oh, no, no, no. I didn't mean you, Professor Norton. I was talking to Sinbad. Huh? Oh, yeah. Right away. Professor Norton says to get the boat ready for a long trip.
Wasn't built to go to the bottom. It'll crack up like an egg when it gets below 2,500 feet.
Oh, nonsense, Joe. Professor Norton knows what he's doing. Go back and help the professor. I'll cast off.
Hold everything!
Oh, we're just leaving. Goodbye.
Goodbye, nothing. I'm going too.
We're nearing the spot where the earthquake shocks originate. Prepare to submerge.
Thank you.
2,500 feet.
Good. Another 2,000 feet and I can start the counteracting ray.
We'll never make it. The submarine will be crushed.
Get hold of yourself, Joe. There's no danger.
Why, of course not.
Well, you're all mad. If we go any deeper, the submarine will crush like the shell of an egg.
Get back there and keep my nose down. We're going through with this.
All right. You ask for it. I'll nose her down. I'll send her straight to the bottom. I'll send her to the bottom of the ocean.
Lock yourself in.
Oh, the wild child.
Over the door.
Open this door, Joe.
I hated to do this, but it was the only way I could stop him. He'll be all right in a little while.
We're down 7,000 feet.
And we're still diving.
Do you think it's safe to continue?
It's the earthquake detector. I'll stop the counteracting ray while you level the ship off. We're down far enough.
Disintegrator.
Must be outside interference, Your Majesty.
We'll soon find out.
So that's what's interfering with my plans.
The deep sea craft from the upper world, Your Majesty. Shall I destroy it?
Wait. I have a better plan.
Turn on the magnetic ray and bring them down into Atlantis.
Professor Norton.
What's happened?
I don't know. We're on a level keel, but we're being dragged down by some mysterious force.
Supreme Majesty Unger Khan, a detachment of the Imperial Guard will proceed at once to the inland sea and capture the stranger from the upper world.
Captain Hackett.
Yes, yes. My horse, quickly. Number one patrol, mount. Number one patrol, prepare to move out. Number two. In another world.
Ah, go, you bastard!
You'd better submerge the submarine while we investigate this place. Better hide the control box.
There's a good place.
Yes, that'll do.
Do you think we'd better wait for Briney and Salty?
Oh, if necessary. They'll join us as soon as they catch Sinbad the Parrot.
My calculations are wrong. We've come across the lost continent of Atlantis.
Oh, I can hardly believe it. It must be a mirage. Some illusion.
Listen.
Why, that's no illusion. Those are hoofbeats.
Look! Soldiers!
Out of sight. We'll find out if they're friends or enemies.
Hey,
out the juggernaut.
Back to the submarine.
But the soldiers, what about them?
I'll tell you later. We have no time to lose.
Hurry, Diana.
What's that?
Some sort of a war tank.
Stop them. Start the disintegrator.